Today, I'll show you how you can add your website to Bing Webmaster Tools, and we'll cover a couple of different methods so you can pick the one that works best for you. So let's dive in. The first method we'll be using is by installing a plugin called All-in-One SEO. We'll be using the light version. All-in-One SEO is a great plugin to help you with your search engine optimization on your website. It will optimize your site search engines without any technical knowledge, and so it's a perfect addition for your website. To get started, let's head over to Plugins, Add New, and from here we're looking for All-in-One SEO. This is the one we want, so let's go ahead and install it, and make sure you stick around to activate it as well. Great, once it's installed, you can either come here to Settings, or now we have an area over here that you can go to. Let's go to All-in-One SEO, and go to General Settings, and now we want to go to Webmaster Tools. From here, we want to select Microsoft Bing. And as you notice, you can also use all of these other items to connect your website with. To add our Bing verification code, we need to go to Bing Webmaster Tools. So we'll open up a new window, search for Bing Webmaster Tools. And this is the one we want to go to. Let's go ahead and click Get Started. And from here, you can sign in through one of these items. And then once you sign in, you are shown with two options that you can do. You can either import from Google Search Console, which I'll show you in just a second, or you can add your site manually. So we'll pick this one for this method and click Add. When you're adding your site manually, make sure that you're using the web address that WordPress uses. For instance, if you have HTTPS, make sure you add HTTPS here. If you're not sure what your site uses, then you can go back to your dashboard, go to Settings, General, and this is your web address that you want to use. You have these three methods that you can choose from. We're going to use the HTML tag method because it's the easiest with All-in-One SEO. You don't have to download and upload files. So simply copy this item. Let's head back over to our dashboard. And if you've moved away from All-in-One SEO, we can go back to All-in-One SEO. We'll go to General Settings, go to Webmaster Tools, select Bing. And now we can paste in that code that we just copied. And let's go ahead and click Save Changes. Once we do that, we can head back over to the Bing area and we can verify. And then you'll get a congratulations, site was verified. So now you're ready to go. The second method is involving another plugin called WPCode. And WPCode is just a really cool plugin that lets you minimize the number of plugins that you need in order to make your site work. To do that, I will remove the verification code for All-in-One SEO. And then we're going to head over to Plugins, Add New. And we're going to search for a plugin, WPCode, all one word. And this is the one we're looking for. So let's go ahead and click Install Now. And activate as well. Cool. Once we're activated, you can either go to Code Snippets here, or what we want to do is go to Code Snippets, and we're looking for headers and footer. And this is where we can add the code that we need to. So we'll go back. And you'll enter the address again. And from here, we also want to copy the meta code again. We'll head back over to our headers and footer section, and we can just paste that in here. And let's go ahead and click Save Changes. Go back to Bing Webmaster, and let's go ahead and verify. The third method that you can do is you can simply import from Google Search Console. So if you've already done this process and submitted your website to Google Search Console, then you can import it from here. When you do get started, you can say import. It's going to connect. You have to continue and sign in with what you want to connect it with and allow access to your account. And then it will go through. And if you have multiple sites, then it will say, hey, we have these others. Do you want all of those? Pick the site that you want. Most people will only have one, and then click import. And it will go out and add it. And now you see, congratulations, site was successful. Once you say it, it'll be a little bit before you can start to see things, but then you should start to see the data, see how many clicks and impressions, click-through rate. You can view the complete report here, and you can also choose to show like the average position as well as a few others. You're going to scroll down and also see some of the keywords that your site is ranking for so that you can start to make some changes to it as well. And if you haven't already connected your site to Google Search Console, then watch this video next as I walk you through step by step on how to add your site to Google Search Console, and I'll see you over there.